It can be a huge benefit to capture directly into Capture One. This way it is possible to see images instantly as you shoot. Still life and studio photographers will find this an invaluable addition to their workflow. To control your Sony camera, first download and install the Remote Camera Control Utility for Sony. It is available for Mac and PC. This utility will allow you to adjust the settings on your Sony camera and also trigger capture. In Remote Camera Control, set the destination to where you want to save your images to. In Capture One Express for Sony, go to the camera menu item and make sure Hot Folder Enabled is checked. Next, choose Select Hot Folder. This will be the same location as the destination for captures that we just set in Remote Camera Control. This will ensure captured images are automatically added to the Capture One catalog and displayed in the viewer. Make a capture in Remote Camera Control by clicking on the camera icon or releasing the camera shutter. The hot folder will now show in the folders area of the library tool, and the image is automatically added to the Capture One catalog as a referenced image in its current location. Adjust camera settings in Remote Camera Control. Each new capture is added to the catalog and automatically displayed in the viewer. Recent captures in catalog collections is a shortcut to the current capture collection as indicated by the date and time. To apply suitable adjustments to all the images, first adjust one image to the preferred result. Then click on the Copy Adjustments icon in the toolbar. Select any other image or images and then click the Apply icon. Capture Pilot is also included in Capture One Express for Sony. Capture Pilot lets you present and rate photos on iOS devices and any other web-enabled device that share the same local network. For Apple products, there is a specific app available from the App Store. Other devices like tablets and computers can simply use any web browser. First, define Capture Pilot sharing settings in the Capture Pilot tool. In the Basic tab, first set the server name or leave it as the default, in this case the catalog name. In the folder pull-down menu, choose which part of the catalog that should be available on Capture Pilot. This is a good way of controlling what images from a shoot can be visible on Capture Pilot. For additional security, include a password. This will be requested on the iOS device or web interface when somebody tries to access Capture Pilot. Under Publish To, decide which devices will have access. Selecting mobile devices will restrict access to iOS devices using the Capture Pilot application only. Choosing web browser enables any other web-enabled device like smartphones, laptops, or other computers. Alternatively, enable both. Use the settings under the mobile tab to control what users accessing your images via the iOS application can do. In the web tab, start by choosing a theme. There are two available which will change the display style in the web browser. Select the permissions as before. Click on Start Image Server in the Basic tab to make Capture Pilot available on the chosen devices. If you are using Capture Pilot on an iPhone or iPad, start the application and tap on the name of the server that was set in Capture One. To see an image in more detail, tap on it once. To star or color rate an image, tap on the star icon and choose a rating. Browse through images with a swipe gesture or use the arrow icons. To work with Capture Pilot on any web-enabled device, open any web browser and key in the IP address shown in the Capture Pilot tool in the web tab. Once the IP information is entered, the images will load as thumbnails. Click on any to see in more detail. As with the Capture Pilot app, it is possible to color and star rate images. Stop the server running to disable Capture Pilot on all devices.